And the best filament brand is?
I often get asked, what's the best filament? This is a really tough question. Nevertheless, I think there are good methods to tell if a filament brand is rather good or bad, and the experienced user community also has its favorites. That's why for this video, I asked you, my community, and some of your favorite 3D printing content creators to determine a winner. I will also show you how to properly compare different filaments, what to look for in technical datasheets, and how to filter marketing nonsense. So let's get right into it, here at JanTec Engineering. Thanks to PCBWay for sponsoring part of this video. First of all, I think it's important to note that I'm not trying to sell you filament with this video. I don't get paid by any filament company, opinions are my own. Keep in mind that there are some affiliate links and discount codes in the video description. Please only use them if you really want to buy at these shops while supporting my work. When doing regular FDM 3D printing, as most of us hobbyists do, thermoplastics are used. They consist of long chains of polymer molecules held together by weak forces, which give them unique mechanical and thermal properties. One characteristic property is their ability to be melted and reshaped multiple times when heated to their specific glass transition or melting temperature. This is what FDM 3D printing takes advantage of by extruding the material through thin nozzle at these temperatures. In the past, many materials were optimized for injection molding, where the challenges can be different from those in 3D printing. ABS is one such material, which is probably why it became one of the first filaments available for DIY 3D printers back in the early days. Over time, as 3D printing grew in popularity, more and more materials were adapted or developed specifically for extrusion as filament. Since there are now so many different brands and material types out there, I wanted to get a better overview of your favorite filaments. I posted this survey on X, Blue Sky, and both my YouTube channels. A total of 72 people responded, which I'm very grateful for. By the way, if you've missed my original post, I'd be very happy to hear about your favorite filament brand and go-to material in the comments. When it comes to the go-to material type, PLA is the clear winner. Over 50% chose PLA as their favorite go-to filament, main reasons being its wide availability, low price, and ease of printing. I won't show you the results of the favorite brand yet, but the chart shows that a lot of people voted for different brands, which is why I later counted each brand with only one or two votes as other. This emphasizes that there are many different brands and the best options highly depend on your region. In India, for instance, it probably makes more sense to look for some locally produced filaments instead of getting filaments made in Europe. We will get to the top 10 brands picked by the community at the end of this video. Next, I wanted to ask some other content creators because they usually get to try out a lot of different filament brands. And where to find a lot of creators in one place? Right, at 3D printing events like RepRap festivals. So I hopped on a plane and flew to Manchester for the Sanjay Mortimer RepRap festival in December 2024. Since I got sick during Smurf, I could only interview very few of the attending creators. That's why I contacted some of them via email.
That is such a hard question because I love so many filaments, as you guys know, but my heart is with Protopasta, which I was so excited about when I first started printing, and I still love their filament.
Hello, my name is Igor from my tech farm. I don't really have a favorite filament brand, maybe Polymaker, Bambu Lab, Sun overall, but some brands have very specific filaments. For example, I really like the PET-CF by CiriaTech. Or, for example, Timori have great PTG reinforced with carbon fibers. It has great layer adhesion.
So when it comes to what my favorite filament brand is, it really depends. But normally, it's just whoever has the color I need, or it happens to already be loaded in the printer.
Hey Jan, thanks for including me in this video. So I have to say that my go-to favorite filament manufacturer has got to be Polymaker, not just because I find that every single filament that I've ever printed from them is super high quality, but they also have the widest range of colors and filaments. And on top of all of that, I love that I can get different filaments that are the exact same color. For example, they have a galaxy black in different kinds of filament if I want to mix and match within a project. So I find myself printing Polymaker most of the time.
My favorite filament brand doesn't matter because it's covered under my electroplating.
My favorite brand, the one I use the most anyway, is Polymaker. They're both supporters of the channel, but also I use the filament a lot before they started supporting the channel, and I love their range of materials. One company I can go to and I can get pretty much everything I need, except for the most beautiful colors and such. They still have great selection, but it's nice to be able to just go one place and get everything.
My favorite material is PETG. It has great mechanical properties. You don't need an enclosure for printing, and it doesn't stink. It's not that unhealthy as ABS is, so it's great for prototyping. See ya.
And then as far as my go-to filament, my audience knows, and hopefully yours will now as well, that I really don't like PETG. The majority of the time I find myself printing either PLA or, if I need a lot of strength, ABS. But I will say that I'm really enjoying experimenting with all the different fun new carbon composites that are coming out, and I look forward to getting into much more of that in 2025.
So I love PLA because it is so versatile and has so many colors, but I'm really starting to like TPU a lot, and there are a lot more great TPUs out there on the market.
And for my favorite filament type, it's gonna be a toss-up between ABS and ASA, although I will be honest, lately I do have a sweet spot for carbon fiber PETG.
My personal favorite material that I work with is ASA. I really like ASA. Polymaker ASA especially prints smooth. Doesn't warp too badly, layer separation's really not an issue. I just find it to be a solid high flow material as well, but when I need to push a printer harder, faster to get a project done faster, it flows really well. So I like it quite a bit for that.
PLA, of course, my favorite filament type is PLA because reasons.
What is my go-to filament? Well, if I need some durable functional part, I'm avoiding the PLA. Usually I will print at least with the PETG, but if I need, for example, stiffness, then I will use carbon fiber reinforced polycarbonate or nowadays PETCF.
Thanks to everyone who participated. I think it's very cool to have so many passionate and talented people in this community. Now let's get to my personal opinion. For my projects, I like to work with Nobufil, Polymaker and some specialized brands. But if I had to choose one, I'd go with Prusament. My go-to material type is the good old PLA.
Before we dive into how to properly compare different filaments using datasheets, I'd like to quickly introduce the sponsor of today's video, PCBWay. PCBWay is your go-to online manufacturing partner for custom PCBs, 3D printing, CNC machining, sheet metal fabrication, and injection molding services. Whether you're working on a hobby project or professional prototype, PCBWay has you covered with high quality manufacturing and competitive pricing. Their platform offers easy file uploads, instant quotes, and reliable shipping, making it effortless to bring your ideas to life. Visit PCBWay.com to learn more and to get special offers and vouchers to save even more on your projects. I think it's really important to know what to look for in a good filament and how to properly compare different offers. Let's start with pricing. One of the biggest misconceptions is comparing filament prices based on cost per kilogram. Different polymers have different densities, so the same weight of different filaments might produce significantly more or fewer parts depending on the material. Here you can see a table with densities of most common filaments. If you print the same part with two materials, it might weigh less simply because one material is less dense. Now take a look at these two offers. Which filament is cheaper? If you compare only the cost per kilogram, you're probably choosing PLA because you get 1 kilogram instead of 850 grams of filament. Here it looks like ASA is around 18% more expensive. But if you consider that ASA has a way lower density and calculate the price in euro per meter using this formula, you come up with a very close price, both at around 9 cents per meter and ASA only being 1.7% more expensive. I get why manufacturers might not display euro per meter on their shop listings, as it could confuse some customers, but honestly, I think bigger shops should consider displaying both prices for higher transparency. You've probably seen filaments that have attachments like Pro, Plus, X or Super Duper Deluxe Tough High Speed PLA++. Okay, the last one was an April's Fool by Polar Filaments, but I think you get what I mean. Let's take PLA Plus as an example. The Plus indicates that there are additives and other materials blended into the PLA, ABS or TPU for example. This can be problematic because people often assume they are still printing PLA, a material considered safe, easy to print on open printers and eco-friendly. But if the Plus includes additives, these assumptions might no longer hold true. Recycling such blends is also much harder, and the additives can sometimes lead to unexpected behavior. When I used ABS-X for a part with hip support and tried to solve the hips in limonene, the ABS also partly dissolved and destroyed the actual component. Regular ABS should be resistant to limonene, so this was a bit sus. Let's talk about carbon fiber reinforced filaments. You've probably heard claims like CF filaments are stronger, but in reality, it's not that simple. First, the carbon fibers in these filaments aren't continuous, instead they are short fibers, often just a few microns long or even just powder added to the polymer mix. When added in small quantities, they don't significantly improve strength or mechanical properties. In fact, carbon fiber reinforcement can even reduce layer adhesion because the fibers are aligned with the filament extrusion direction. This means that they don't provide reinforcement in the Z direction where the parts are already weakest. That said, there are technical filaments like PACF or PCCF where the addition of carbon fibers does make sense. These materials benefit from increased stiffness and reduced warping, making them excellent for functional parts. But don't fall for the marketing hype that adding carbon fibers automatically makes any filament better. Now let's talk about technical datasheets, TDS for short, and how to properly use them to compare filaments. For common and well-known materials such as ABS, there are reference values available online and in books. For filaments, you should better not rely on these values because, as mentioned earlier, every filament manufacturer gets their raw resins from different sources and blends it with different additives. Luckily, most brands provide datasheets that include the most important information about the mechanical, thermal, and printing properties. To understand them and to be able to interpret them correctly, there are some things you should know. First, different companies use different testing methods and norms. Sometimes the smallest details can lead to huge differences in a result. Impact resistance, for instance, can be measured using a regular sample or a notched sample. The notch leads to way lower impact resistance. Keep that in mind, especially when comparing filaments from different brands. Second, since the base material resins are usually transparent or opaque, so-called master batch is added to give the filament the desired color. Depending on different factors, I've heard about adding 1 to 5% master batch. CNC Kitchen made a good video about the impact of color on different mechanical properties. For instance, white PLA had 15% better tensile strength than matte black PLA. I've linked the full video in the description. So when you really want to rely on the datasheet, keep that in mind and try to avoid crazy colors or additives such as glitter, silk or rainbow effects. Some datasheets point this out, others do not even state the color that was used for their testing. Third, in some cases, you might find values for injection molded parts. That's obviously not very helpful when 3D printing. Make sure to look up the values in the right column. Fourth, the actual properties highly depend on the print settings and conditions such as printing temperatures, nozzle material, if the printer is enclosed or not, and more variables. In good datasheets, it's stated how the tested samples were printed to get an idea of what's achievable with the print settings. All in all, I would say that datasheets should only be used for a rough estimation. Now let's get to the results of my previous survey about the favorite brand and the go-to material. According to the opinions from the community, the winner would be Polymaker. But please take this with a grain of salt, as this outcome is based on 72 opinions and not actual facts. Here you can see the top 10 brands, leaving out those with only 1 or 2 votes. Do you agree with this? Let me know in the comments. As said, the best option for you highly depends on your region, needs and budget.
Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to not miss any further content.